Golden Spike Burgers features a menu with everything from hamburgers and fries to gyros. They are also open for breakfast with items like breakfast burritos, bagel sandwiches, and the old standby bacon, eggs, and pancakes.
The Bear River High School Bears traveled to Preston, Idaho on August 24th to take on the Preston Indians in a rematch of a game last year. The Bears won that game in a tight contest at home, and the Indians were out for blood. The Indians got the ball first and were able to march down the field, but could not punch the ball in the red zone. Tyson Lombreras ended up shredding the Bear defense for 175 yards, but the Indians were able to only score one time. On the Bears' first possession, they tried to run the ball against the Indian defense to no success.
RJ Harris.
But then some changes were made, and senior quarterback Kyle Zundel hooked up with Colton Jensen on this long scoring pass. The Bear River offense ended up exploding for 287 yards of offense through the air on the way to a 44-6 win over the Indians. Kyle, totally different offense this week. A lot more passing, great success on the passing game versus running last week. What happened today?
They just let our passing game open, so we saw a void in it and we decided we were going to hit it. Just a great job by our offensive line, stepping up, great protection, and receivers running their right routes, hitting the void.
In the second quarter, Zundel connected with Garrett Franck on a 19-yard pass. After a Jared Olson PAT and later a field goal, the Bears were up 17-0. What was the philosophy as you hit the field today?
Our defense knew that they're going to be a power offense, and our offense just worked on what we thought they were going to give us a look at.
Coach Chris Wise, after a big win over Preston. Coach, you came into this game really not knowing much about the Indians other than they would run the ball, and they ran the ball, but you guys did a great job on defense. 6 points is all they got.
Well, and the defense did an outstanding job. We knew that they were going to try and really pound it. They had some huge offensive linemen. That was no slack team. I think they're going to do well in their region. We started a little bit flat, and whenever you can pull yourself out of that, that's a good experience, and so we learned a little bit that way, especially going into our boxing league.
You came out with a run first kind of look, and then some things were seen and changes were made, and suddenly Zundel became a BYU quarterback.
Well, that's the philosophy of what we're trying to do, is take what they give us. There are things built into every play to be able to do that, and I think that's one of the great things of the offense, is especially if the quarterback's paying attention, there are openings. So he did a great job of finding those openings tonight. Yeah, Colton Jensen did a great job. He's got the kind of speed that he can get behind most people, and so we need to be able to use that, and obviously that takes being able to protect our quarterback. I thought we did a great job that way. Offensive line-wise, we did a good job that way, and Kyle did a good job of fighting the open man and reading his keys and getting the ball to him, so I was very pleased with that.
With the game in hand in the second half, the Bears were able to get several substitutions made, including junior quarterback Jardy Nesson.
There you go, bro.
Nesson was able to direct the Bears to two fourth quarter scores, including this one that Tyson Palm pounded in from 1 yard out. The Bears had 405 yards of total offense, including 287 through the air. The Indians managed 237 yards of total offense, with only four coming through the air. Tyler Rasmussen had 10 tackles and an interception for the Bears. Taylor Lund added 8 tackles and Austin Miller 7. Now the Bears get ready for Box Elder, who invade the Bear Den Friday. Next week you've got Box Elder, another tough physical game, running team. What do you expect in that game?
Expect to grind it out with them. expect them to come out and play tough, and we'll come out and play tough too.
Bears haven't had a lot of success against the Bees the last few years. What are you hoping to accomplish other than a win, obviously?
Just to compete, mainly. Always competing.
Very physical, run-oriented team, things we all are used to. What do you expect there?
Well, they should be very good. I expect them to go deep in the 4A playoffs. When you talk rivalry weeks, you can throw all the this team's better, that team's better stuff out the window because everybody raises their game.
There's a little bit of pride at stake too because they're cross-county rivals, playing these guys forever, last chance. Any extra motivation for you?
Of course, there's always motivation going in playing Box Elder, especially at home.
And I've got Shad Watson kind of running the show. Everybody knows about Shad, a college-type kid. How do you stop a kid like that?
He's a young kid, and although he's a great player all around, he's a great athlete all the way around, if we can confuse him a little bit with what we're doing defensively, then we've got a shot.
Golden Spike Burgers also has a low-cost menu for all students. This is their second restaurant in the area, with the first successful store located in Corinne. Come meet their friendly staff and enjoy good food.